Welcome back to another video. I'm Adam from WP Crafter, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies. And in this video, I'm going to show you a new module that was just released for the Elementor Pro plugin. Now, Elementor is the free page builder for WordPress, and it's the most feature-rich freely available page builder for WordPress, but they also have a pro version right here, and you can go here and find out information. I've got a link down below. I also have a coupon code if you're interested in purchasing it, and I have a free bonus offer where I am giving you access to my Elementor Essentials course. It's a $97 course, but you're going to get that for free. Let's take a look at this new flip box feature that was recently added to Elementor. Now, one of the things I like about Elementor, first off, let's just get this out there. When they started selling the pro version of their plugin, actually, let me scroll down to where it is. Here's the page for their pro version. It came out in December 2006. And they hadn't released everything for it yet that they wanted to, these pro modules. So you can see all these pro modules here that they really wanted to release, but they hadn't yet. And they are making good on what they said they would do. So they're showing a carousel, a flipbox, Twitter feed, MailChimp, and they're doing more than that, but they're actually making good on that. So this is the flipbox that was just released. So you're going to find it after you update. You're going to find it in your pro elements, and it's right here called Flipbox. Now, this update actually has some other updates as well that I'll show you, but right now it is just the Flipbox. So I'm going to go ahead and drag and drop it in there. Now, this is obviously probably not how you would use your Flipbox. You would probably have maybe a section that has maybe three or four columns in it. So let's go ahead and do that now. I'm going to click on Add New Section. Let's just go with three columns. And then I am going to drag and drop this into the column here. Okay, here is my Flipbox. And let's just duplicate that a little bit and move it around. So now I have a section with three Flipboxes. Now, let's talk a little bit about Flipbox etiquette. I actually don't like flip boxes like this. You see how it just flips? I actually kind of find it a little annoying if I'm on a website and I just hover my mouse and you get this crazy flip here. Now, the good thing about Elementor Pro is the Flipbox feature that they have has different actions for the instead of flipping. So you don't have to just flip. So I'm going to click on it here and get into the settings, and then I'm going to collapse this and go to the settings of this particular Flipbox. And so you get this flip effect here, and you can see it comes with six different effects. So I'm not really a flip type of guy. So let's see what the slide looks like. And that's okay. It's kind of dramatic. So that probably wouldn't be my first pick either. The push, this is the push. You saw the difference is it's pushing the content up. And so that's push, and you also have directions. You can push it different directions. So if I wanted to push it left like that, you can see it's a little easier on the eye than the flip. Let's see, the slide, I had options for that as well. Now let's look at some of the other ones, the zoom in. Now, I like the zoom in. I like this type of effect. It has a more subtleness to it. It's a bit more elegant in my opinion. Let's look at the zoom out. So there's the zoom out. I really like the zoom in and the zoom out. And then this is probably the most elegant of them all, is a simple fade. When you hover over it, you get a nice simple fade like that. Now, each of these sides, you have settings that you can use. So the first side is just side A. Now, for each side, you have two layers. The top layer is going to be your content layer, and then the bottom layer is going to be your background. And when you choose a background, you have your typical options. You can have it be classic, which is an image, and then maybe a cover overlaid over that, or you could go straight to a gradient if you wanted. So for me, I will choose the classic, and I'm going to go and pick a background image. Now, I have some good food images here, so let's go ahead and choose maybe this image right there. And then you can see, though, when you do that and you have text on it, you kind of want to put a color overlay so it makes it easier to read that text. So to do a color overlay, you would just scroll down here to cover overlay. Let's try to pick a nice bright color. maybe something like this. And then we have to adjust our opacity so we can have it be a little bit of a see-through like that. So you can really have it do whatever you want. If you want some color like this, you could do that. And that will make the text a little easier to read just like that. And then you can come to content and choose whatever content you want, your title, your description. Now, what's one of my favorite things about Elementor is they have this style tab and you can style everything. You can style your fonts, your text, every aspect of this can be styled. So that is the basics of using a flip box. So let's take a look at this one right here and see if we can actually create something that's useful. So let me go ahead and choose the classic. Let's choose an image. I'm going to choose a darker image, maybe this pizza right here. And I want a color overlay, but this time I'm going to go with a darker color. So I'm going to go black and then let's just make it a little see-through like that. So you can really see that text. I'm probably not a fan. Let me go back to content. Probably not a fan of having an icon at all. So I'm going to get rid of the icon like that. You don't have to have one. And technically, you don't actually have any kind of text. I can get rid of the title and the description if I just wanted an image there. Now, I'm going to go with the fade effect. I'm kind of thinking that that's going to be my favorite effect. I like subtle transitions like that. So let me just jump in there and change the effect to a fade like that. And then let it fade to something different. That's great. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into slide B and let's go ahead and set that background. I'm going to choose an image. And so I did the pizza this time. Actually, you know, it'd be interesting if you hovered and the color just changed. That might be a real creative use for it. So when I'm hovering right now, we don't see any kind of change, but let's see if I make that overlay a more prominent color. So let's go with a green here and let's maybe go like that. So, and then some opacity in there. So there we go. Let's see what happens when we do that. So let's click back to slide A and then let's collapse the interface here and see what happens. So when I cover it, like hover over it like that, you can see the color overlay is changing and the text is changing. So it's a more elegant way to use a flip box and have it be more of a subtle transition to maybe display some more information. So this is the flip box. I think you could do some very creative things with it. I think it's a very powerful add-on that was just included in the pro version of Elementor. Now, if you don't have Elementor Pro, I've got some great news for you. I have a special discount code that's valid right now. I don't know how long it's going to be valid for, but with this coupon code, you're going to be able to take 10% off the cost of Elementor Pro. Now, what you need to do is click on the link down below in the pinned comment or the link in the description. Head over to Elementor's website, choose the package for Elementor Pro that you want, and when you're checking out, enter WPCrafter10 to save 10%. Now, what you want to do, if you want access to the course, if you would like me to enroll you in this course for free, just go ahead and contact me, forward me a copy of your receipt. I'll verify that you purchased it through the link that I provided, and I'll gladly enroll you in the course. And I'd love to see in the comments down below what you do with this flip box feature, or if you have any links to websites that have really good examples of using a flip box in an elegant way. I would really love to see those so that we can kind of put our minds together on the best way to use this powerful new feature. Because you made it to the end of the video, I have a free gift for you. But before I talk about that, I want to ask you to do something for me. If you could give this video a thumbs up down below, that would really help me out. If you're not subscribed to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button and become a subscriber and support this channel. And if you'd like YouTube to notify you when I upload new videos, there's a little bell next to that subscribe button. You can click on that and set that up as well. If you have any questions or a comment about this video, I'd love to answer it. There's a comment section down below. All you have to do is put in your question or comment. I respond to every single one. Hey, I made a course just for you, and it's called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success, and I want to give this to you. If you'd like to enroll in this course, there's a button right here off to the right. You can go ahead and click on that, enroll as a student, and that's just my way of saying thank you for supporting me and making it to the end of this video. I make them just for you.